of your marketplace, and we can go forward how to go about it. So probably Hitesh can help you with the branding. So
sure.
When your business scales up,
people will try to copy the brand name and copy. Lot of textile is core to that. People know what's the B brand. If you know brand, prepare manufacture product, low quality product excellent. So to avoid that, in future, first register your brand, trademark policy. There's a government website called IP0.in. Whoever presents you can also look into that, and you will get to know whether the brand is available to you or not.
Thank you for that valuable
information. One more thing I would also like to suggest you when it comes to financing. Please be very clear how much you would grow for the long term and the working capital. If you are not able to allocate between your long term and working capital, and if your working capital, if your long term funding eats into your working capital which you have already taken across, it could lead to a huge disadvantage for you to do the business. So be very, very careful, plan it up well, sit with sir, and once understand exactly your requirements, bifurcate it into long term and short term, and working capital and the capex, and then go ahead with it.
Sure. Thank you. Let me move on to Mr. Hitesh for inputs on branding and marketing.
Yeah, Tushar. So have you already decided on the brand name which you're planning to go
for? We're calling it the Changing Seasons.
Okay. So adding to Mukesh's point of registering the brand, I would also ask you to check the brand name availability with the website, and you know, so that you can block those websites immediately. Have you already identified a target audience for this brand?
Yeah, so we the target audience is going to be the youth.
Okay.
And we're looking at tier one cities.
Okay. So if your target audience is youth, then your brand name should be. Yeah, the brand name suits well the changing seasons. It has to have a lot of color into the brand. The logo and the punchline should be around youth. And you need to design complete corporate guidelines, brand guidelines that includes right from your stationery to packaging. In retail, you will need a good signage guidelines. So all your stores across cities look same. That's how you create a good brand. Not just that, but also having small little things going into detail. For example, even a water bottle that you serve inside your stores should have the brand, and things like those. So that adds a lot of value to the brand. Apart from that, I think you should also focus on having wall graphics, wall branding on your stores, which is equal, uniform all across. You can also use parallel channels for your delivery vehicles and all, which are doing branding on the vehicles. That's a free of cost marketing. You don't have to pay for the advertisements, and it's a free eye grabbers. You can also have, you need to have some digital signage, because this is age of digital, and you can add digital signage into your stores. That will help you a lot. You can do a lot of interactive stuff with the customers, doing live polling, taking feedbacks, etc. As far as the marketing is concerned, you'll have to plan both ATL, which is above the line marketing activities, and BTL, which is below the line marketing activities. So ATL includes social media. You need to have presence in various social medias. I would definitely recommend you, since it's related to fashion and youth, you have to be present on Pinterest, Instagram, Snapchat, and then TV, newspaper ads. You'll have to have some fixed budgets every year for having some kind of above-the-line activities. And as important as above-the-line activities, it's even BTL, which is below-the-line activity, is very important, which is very local, doing road shows, maybe sponsoring some college events, college fairs, having some direct mailing activities, etc. And digital marketing today is very, very important, because digital marketing is taking care of both above the line and below the line activities. So you can do very, very focused and targeted marketing using digital marketing channels. And so You want to add something?
Yeah, this is Tushar. I also want to add something to that. Basically, why brand is required? So this is, we are fortunate in our first point, ki, the time that we are going to start the business, there are so many mediums where we can establish our brand. But if it is 15, 20 years back, then only was a very costly medium, one or two, where we could improve our brand. But today, well, there are so many social media as it is nightly seen. But the point is now, our 350 GTV of growth in people are sitting here. So I think we should say that okay, why brand is very important. Brand is very important. I think the importance, Rajendra Ji Gandhi was sitting here, you would definitely understand why he made his brand so big. Because once your brand establishment, what I mean is, then it runs by its own. That is not a very important, you should create your brand. That is what I want to this way.
Tushar, another piece of advice on working for registrations under the compliance. You don't only go for the present line of numbers of regular garments and textiles, you also do the registration for aligned products like accessories, belts, etc. and all that. Because in the future, when you want to do that, you should not be taking any compliance. It will be a product based registration. I think Mr. Surana could explain that also.
As I told you earlier, there are a lot of copycats in the market. So it's better you design your product line in the beginning and then you start promoting things so that you scale up your business faster. And before that, I would like to know whether you identify your team, your managers, your staff, your marketing managers, and your housekeeping. If all that is in place, because if the number of employees are more than 5 or 10, you'll have to register under EPF organization.
I think we'll take the expert's opinion also here, Mr. Mott, on business, people, processes. Because if you're looking at creating something worth 100 crores in the next 3 years, I'm sure we'll need the bandwidth to go to that target.
Exactly. Tushar, jaisa ki kaha jata hai ki well begin is half done. So, sabse important, मैं ये मानता हूँ कि आपने डिसाइड कर लिया है कि 100 करोड़ बिजनेस मुझे करना है. अदरवाइज हम ये सोचते रह जाते हैं कि कितना बिजनेस मुझे करना है. बिकॉज आज हमारे पास सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट चीज़ है कि हम कोई बिजनेस स्टार्ट करते तो हम ये डिसाइड नहीं कर पाते हैं कि मुझे कितना बिजनेस करना है. तो मैं आपसे ये पूछना चाहूँगा कि 100 करोड़ जो आपने अपने फील्ड के अंदर सोचा है, ये मार्केट शेयर का कितना परसेंट आप लेना चाहते हो, वो एक कैलकुलेशन लगा के बैलेंस शीट के रूप में उसको सोचा है ना कि मैं 100 करोड़ कितना परसेंटेज मुझे लेना है. अगर वो आपने ऑलरेडी आपने 100 करोड़ सोच लिया तो उसकी फिर आगे की जर्नी बहुत इजी मुझे. तो ये मुझे थोड़ा सा बताइएगा कि 100 करोड़ जो आपको मार्केट शेयर लेना है, ये क्या सोच के आपने उसको मतलब डिसाइड किया कि मुझे इतना करना है. आपकी मार्केट शेयर कितना है, उसमें से कितना परसेंटेज आप लेना चाहते हैं?
सो करेंटली जितने भी कॉम्पिटिशन है, कम्पीटिंग ब्रांड्स है, तो दिस परसेंटेज इज टेकन बाय लुकिंग एट द ओवरऑल मार्केट शेयर, who is having how much in the pie, and probably we are targeting to reach about to reach at about 8% of the share in the bigger pie. That is the target.
Then definitely, see, since your vision is 100 crore within 3 years, I think definitely we'll have to set a really a goal as well as infrastructure in your office. So I think you will have to appoint a CEO, and then CEO will decide his finance department, HR department, then there will be a sales department, purchase department, and definitely today's world, what I feel according to my business, what I saw and the way we have grown, only morning till evening eating technology, you know, looking technology. So if you really want to create 100 crore business, you would require a technology in every place, all the best practices available you require, and that is only possible when you use your technology. Suppose how I think according to my business is, suppose a HR, we appoint as a HR, so I never say I want an HR. I want a leader. Because the typical HR, what I have seen from AJ is he only looks at typical HR shit. You know, so aaj ki date, see, 15, 20 years back, it is all required because us samay hamare paas koi metrics, payroll, aur ye sab nahi hua karte. Aaj ki date mein hamare paas technology available hai. So jab aapko 100 crore business start karna hai, to definitely you would require HR who would appoint a good employment. So आपको ये देखना होगा कि हर जगह पे मैं हर डिपार्टमेंट के अंदर मैं एक ऐसा टेक्नोलॉजी डालूं जो मुझे तो सोचने पे फ्री करे, मतलब यू नो मैं फ्री हूँ, और साथ ही साथ मेरे उस डिपार्टमेंट के लीडर को भी वो सोचने पे ज़्यादा काम कराए इरेस्पेक्टिव ऑफ डेली रूटीन वर्क में. तो जहाँ जहाँ जो टेक्नोलॉजी अवेलेबल है जैसे मैट्रिक्स है, पेरोल है, अलग अलग इस तरीके से आपका वो डिपार्टमेंट उसको क्रिएट कर ले। सेल्स डिपार्टमेंट, परचेज डिपार्टमेंट, परचेज डिपार्टमेंट डेफिनेटली नाउ एवरीथिंग इज हैपनिंग विद द डाउनलोडिंग बिल्स, मेनी मेनी यू नो अवेलेबल नो एंट्री, पीपल डज नॉट नो दैट। अगर हम उसको सोच के अगर उस टेक्नोलॉजी को हम लगाते हैं तो शायद बिजनेस हमारा जिस स्पीड से ग्रो होता है उस स्पीड से हमारा एम्प्लॉयमेंट ग्रो नहीं होता है। वो एक इम्पॉर्टेंट ये रहता है कि ऑलवेज मनी सेव इज मनी हर्न, तो वहाँ आपका जो ROI देखे या EBITDA देखे उस टर्म्स में आप काफ़ी ग्रो कर पाते हो। सो टेक्नोलॉजी इज मोस्ट मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट इन एवरी डिपार्टमेंट। एंड लाइव एग्जाम्पल आई विल टेल यू नाउ, सम 15-20 ईयर्स बैक व्हेन वी स्टार्टेड आवर बिजनेस वी वर डूइंग सम 1 crore rupees पर एनम एंड आई वाज हैविंग ओनली 5 पीपल इन परचेज डिपार्टमेंट एंड टुडे वी हैव मेड सम 5 crore 50 crore। आज भी मेरे पास 5 एम्प्लॉई हैं परचेज डिपार्टमेंट बिकॉज वी यूज टेक्नोलॉजी। तो मुझे ये लगता है कि आप इनोवेशन पर ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा ध्यान दें। इनोवेशन पे आप जब ध्यान देंगे तो डेफिनेटली आपका बिजनेस स्मूथ वे में आगे बढ़ेगा। एंड सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट ये रहेगा जब टेक्नोलॉजी है तो आपके एरर्स बहुत कम्प्लीट होंगे। तो मेरा ये मानना है कि आप ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा टेक्नोलॉजी एंड देन मार्केट प्लेस विजन, बिकॉज सिंस वी आर लिविंग इन इंडिया तो यहाँ पर हमारे पास कोई ऐसा जैसे डाटा अवेलेबल नहीं है कि मैं इस बिज़नेस के अंदर अगर ये बिज़नेस इतना मार्केट शेयर है तो मैं इसमें इतना परसेंट ले पाऊँ। हमें एक अंदाज से हमारे बिज़नेस को सेट करना पड़ता है। तो एक और जो मैंने बेनिफिट देखा कि हमें अपने आप से कंपटीशन नहीं करके, जब हम अपने आप से कंपटीशन कर रहे होते हैं संजय जी, तो क्या होता है कि जैसे मैं एक अमाउंट बिजनेस कर रहा हूँ तो हम इतना ही सोच पाते हैं कि 10% 20% कैसे ग्रो होना। लेकिन जब लगता है कि हमें बहुत बड़ा है और उसके अंदर से अगर हम 2-5% भी शेयर ग्रैब करना चाहें तो हम बिजनेस को बहुत आगे यू नो तेज गति से आगे बढ़ा पाएं।
तुषार वर्मा से यू आर interest in the way how business is happening. There's a huge change in the way you do business. Though the businesses are the same, the consumption is the same on the same item, the way things are being done is very different today. And you are getting into an industry which has a lot of fashion change. Because of the technology today, because of the social media today, your industry changes much faster. Earlier we used to wear lungis, we used to wear trousers, when you have a combo of $20. So these are the things which are going to change. So I would also suggest you to come out with a division which is the futuristic division of yours, which is also looking into what would sell tomorrow. Most of us look out at what the market is for today and we start focused on that. I think you should look into the concept and have a team dedicated. This is going to eat into a lot of your cost. Okay, so but that you have to understand one thing is that if you're not going to see or visualize what is going to be working 3 years later, 5 years later, you would not survive, because the best of the companies which were doing fantastic 5 years, 10 years back have collapsed today.
All right.
One last thing. Vinod Bhai said about HR. I would suggest you have a consultant who does your PF, because if you're manufacturing, the lot of things I've seen, companies shut down because labor force is striking. And you need a proper person to do your consultancy, get all the forms filled for employees and filed before the authorities. So initially when you start, have less number of staff, register with PF. If you're having more than 50, if you're having manufacturing, then you have to register under the Factories Act, and any incident there will be a big hazard, big setback. So be careful when you have an HR, have a consultant along with him to do a factory, ESI, PF and all the compliances in place.
And also keep a provision for your gratuity payments which may happen after. So many times you don't do that and then your cost will go.
The gratuity payments is like multiples into number of years of service. So consultant will tell you when to retention, when to take him back and all that. So that's why you need a consultant for ESI, PF to advise you like your HR or your finance is done.
So one last advice, Tushar, is have a single common number for all your multiple stores. Try and have a common playlist running as a music at the background. Create a ringtone of your own brand, which helps a lot to connect with people. And yeah, be present everywhere, Google Maps, Facebook, and that's the message.
Well, all inputs taken. Thank you so much for your time and appreciate the same.
From all the panelists, I would only like to say, improve your vision to 1,000 crores. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, friends, panelists and Tushar. Well, as rightly Benjamin Franklin said, by failing to prepare, you are preparing to fail. and this insight is for us to be prepared and make us future ready for what is lined up. Well, friends, just to set the context right, this role play was just a small insight about how technology can help you grow your business to the level or to the dreams that you would like to achieve. And let me... Thank you. Well, friends, help me invite the hero to ensure that we all get the insight about this. It gives me immense pleasure in introducing today's speaker to this August gathering. Belonging to Falodi in Rajasthan, he was born to Shri Kantilalji Bachawat and Srimati Pushpabai in the year 1974 in Kunnur district of Tamil Nadu. And become graduate, he completed his formal education in Calicut and moved to Bangalore in the year 1998 and joined Vardhaman Pharma as manager for business automation. His journey towards the business automation and technological advancement started from there, and he started his own company in the year 2002, C Square IT Solutions Private Limited. In the past 17 years, C Square has served more than 4,000 business houses and helped them to excel to great proportions, and some of them growing to over 200 times in a span of 10 years. I think rightly, the way Vinodji said, I'm sure he also works on the C Square platform and has been able to achieve great propositions in this past 15 years. Well, friends, more than 70% of the pharma software works on C Square software. Some of his clientels are Mahir MediSales, Ratsans Pharma, Pasolite, GM Switches, Lakshmi Sales. Well, not just that, they spread their digital footprints from a software